we are exercising and we're doing high load exercise, that higher hip is always vulnerable. But that does not mean that the lower hip doesn't have any issues occurring either. The lower hip can have hip stabilizers going into spasm constantly because it's trying to stabilize. And the higher hip is on holiday in the stabilizer front, but it's finding other frames such as TFL, piriformis, to jump in issues. The next one we have is our gluteus medius, which is one of our main hip stabilizers, and it's a multifunctional muscle. However, this muscle can be cancelled out, especially if you have an individual who favors an anterior pelvic tilt, because the tensor fascia lata then jumps in and says, you know what, I'm in front, you're so weak, especially because your hip is higher, so you're constantly in adduction, so I can do all this hip stability. You can see that on the image above, where it gets that concave curve on that right hip that is higher. The next one is hip bursitis.
I could feel mine kicking in while I was standing there on the pillow.
Pronation, a good neutral foot, supination, and over supination.
With this individual. So that's what we're going to run through right now. Tanya's going to be my client, and her right hip is the IA hip. So that's where she's got her issue. Okay. So the first exercise, lying on your back for me, please. You can put your feet up against the bar there. So I put the feet up against the bar. It just makes it a bit nicer over the knees. Arms relax down next to your side. Palms are facing up. So her right hip is higher. But first, we'll start with a bit of bilateral work. And as we go through the program, we'll go over to unilateral work equally versus the right one. Contracting into your glutes again. Squeezing nice and tight. Keeping that lateral rotation. Hold it there. Squeeze your left one just a little bit more. There we go. And then release. Just be against the bar or against the wall. Hands behind your head, interlace your fingers. So in this position, you want to encourage pushing that pubic bone into the ball, getting that tuck through with the pelvis, so you're lengthening the spine.